Yes. Children, in this figure, in question 14, we are given, this figure is given as it is, that DB is thrice of CD, right? I would say whenever you are given any relation between two sides, like twice, thrice, four times, whatever, you first figure it out. What does it mean? You first put it in simpler form. Like we are given DB is thrice of CD. So I would say first you take CD to be X. Let us take CD to be X. Then DB will be thrice of CD. That means 3X.
Yes, ma'am.
And what will be BC? BC will be
4X.
So whatever is given, we could simplify that in terms of X, and we have done that. So part one is over. Clear? Now moving on to the next is to prove. What we have to prove is twice of AB square equal twice of AC square plus BC square. Children, we don't have to worry about 2, 3, whatever the number is here initially. As I have been always telling you, whenever there is 90 degree in the question and you are talking of square of the side, apply which theorem?
Pythagoras.
If I look at LHS, the focus is on AB square. AB square I will get from which of these two triangles? These are the two right triangles.
ADB.
ADB.
Yes. Let us apply Pythagoras theorem in triangle ADB. What we shall get?
AB square plus AD square is equal to AD square plus DB square.
All right. This is what I have obtained. Now let us focus on what is to be proved. AB square is needed. That is why we started with this triangle. Do we need AD square?
No, ma'am.
AD square is not needed. AD square is not needed. How about BD square?
No, ma'am.
BC learning
is yes. Yes. Very correct. BD is not needed as it is, but we need BC. And BD and BC are related with X. Yes? They are somehow related with X. So we shall not disturb this. But AD square we do not need at all. Instead of AD square, I need AC square. Instead of AD square, I need AC square. Now from the figure beta, anything, any triangle which gives you the connection between AD and AB. Yes,
ACD.
ACD.
This triangle. If I apply Pythagoras theorem in this triangle, what will I get?
AC square is equal to
AD square plus CD square.
Will it mean AC square minus CD square?
Yes,
yes,
ma'am.
Yes.
Bolo. Will it mean AC
square
minus CD square? Yes, ma'am.
I'm writing here by using Pythagoras theorem in triangle ACB. By using Pythagoras theorem in triangle ACD. Clear?
Ma'am?
Yes, beta.
Ma'am, ye wala part nahi samajh aaya.
See na, bachche, see. In triangle ACD, what do we have? We have AD square plus CD square is equal to AC square. Perpendicular square plus base square. Hai na? So this would mean that AD square is equal to AC square minus CD square.
Yes, ma'am.
Ma'am, zaruri hai likhna by using Pythagoras in triangle. Or ma'am, direct hum nahi likh sakte ye AD wala humne kiya hai baad mein.
This you have to write. This reason to you will have to write that you are applying Pythagoras theorem. You may avoid what I have written in red, but this reason you have to write. Clear, children? So moving on next, AC square as it is. Now CD and BD, let us put them in terms of X because I need BC. So what is CD?
3X.
x square and BD is 3x whole square. So it will be AC square minus x square plus 9x square.
9x square.
Yes, ma'am.
AC square. This will give me
plus 8 square. Plus 8x square.
Now I have obtained this in the simplified form. I have obtained this in the simplified form. But if I focus on what is to be proved, what we need is twice of AB square. What we need is twice of AB.
Twice of AB.
So I shall multiply this by 2. Because yes. I need 2 here. Always remember, children, solve the question in the simplest form. And in the last step, whichever number you need, 2, 3, 4, 5, whatever, just multiply with that. So this gives me twice of AC square is equal to twice of AC square plus 16x square. Now, yes. twice of AC square I need as it is 16x square
plus 4x square.
And what is 4x?
BC.
Are we done?
Yes, ma'am.
Hence, proof.
Yeah? Yes, ma'am.
Vinayak.